put so much time and effort into creating your campaigns and automations. Wouldn't it be wonderful to see how they perform? Luckily, MailerLite has a built-in analytics and stats tool, so you can keep track of where your subscribers are in your automation. We'll show you how to check your workflow history to see all of your recent changes, manage your subscribers in the activity section, and analyze the stats so you know exactly how your workflows are performing. Let's get into it. To view the automation stats, select Automation, choose the workflow you'd like to review, and click on Overview. The Settings button here allows you to edit, rename, duplicate, or delete the workflow. And in the workflow overview, you can see the trigger of the automation, how many subscribers completed the automation, and how many are in the queue. In this section, we can see the total number of emails sent, how many were opened, clicked, and what is the click-to-open rate. You can also see the number of subscribers who unsubscribed, reported spam complaints, and bounced. These are your subscribers' reading environments and the top email clients they use to read your content. In the monthly workflow stats, you can see how many emails were sent each month and the monthly stats. You can take a look at the past 3 months to a year, and you can also export this information. At the very bottom, you'll see the emails included in this workflow, and by clicking on the report button, you'll be able to review the stats of each one of them individually, which is just like any regular campaign report. On the activity page, you can see the number of subscribers that are queued, completed, canceled, or failed. And you can also narrow your search by choosing specific dates right here. When a subscriber shows up in a queued category, it means that they're waiting at a delay on a workflow step. To remove them from that queue, select them, click Actions, Remove from Queue. You can also skip the delay for a subscriber, which will send them to the next step in the workflow, and that will also change their status. Now here, since we've chosen to skip the delay on the last step, we can see that this subscriber is now showing in the completed category. In this category, the completed status shows those subscribers who have successfully completed all of the steps in your workflow. If you see a subscriber in the canceled or failed categories, it means that they've been removed from the workflow, and you should be able to see the reason why they were removed in the next column right here. To add these subscribers back into the workflow, select them, click the Actions button, and select Re-add to Sequence, and you will see the option to add them back to the step they were last on or send them to a new step in the workflow. You can also export the subscribers list right here. If you're looking for a specific subscriber and have their name or email address, you can easily find them right here. The history page presents an up-to-date report of all of the activities that happened in this workflow. Here you can see when subscribers were added and when the workflow was updated, when it was activated, and when it stopped. You can use the filter to choose specific timeline and look at all or focus on when the automation was activated or deactivated. You can also review the activity history by date or by action and change the order from first to last or vice versa.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to click the bell button below so you don't miss any new tutorials. You can also find us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and subscribe to our newsletter. The link is in the description section below. Have an awesome day or night, and I'll see you in the next video.